my inspiration for this film came when I was studying in Germany, making a course in Berlin for filmmaking. And the idea of living in Cairo or and having seen how life in Berlin is very calm, nice, and very youth-friendly. I always had the idea of I would love to live in European Berlin, but at the same time there's a lot of things that are holding you back in Cairo, like family and the people around you love and care for. And I think this is where the idea of the film came from, but also that a great-grandmother of mine had Alzheimer's, and I saw how my grandfather took care of her, even to the stage, very late stages, to when he fed her with his hands, with the spoon. Yeah. So I saw this scene, and since I've seen it, it stuck into my memory. And then when I started writing a short film to make for the course, this idea came for a guy who left already his city and is returning to visit his mother who he had left. But then it took, that was, like 5 years before I started making the film, and then it developed until the very late idea of him actually having a dilemma of whether he should leave or stay with her. So in the beginning he had already made the choice and was coming back to visit, but then I thought maybe the dilemma of the choice, leaving or staying, has a lot of more of emotional struggle, and that I could make a better film out of this moment. And it took it took a couple of years. I did a couple of projects in between, but the shooting was only, it took 2 days. And post-production also wasn't a very hectic process, because it was very easy. I shot exactly where I would cut. Mm-hmm. So post-production was just like putting them all together. I knew the shots, and maybe 2 or 3 weeks or something with the mixing, and we had no music. It was a decision. And we recorded on set the sound, so it was a very easy process technically. The writing process took a while. The creative decisions took a lot of more of an energy. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then in the shoot itself, how the different visions. A very unique vision, like it's not a normal. We didn't show anyone but the protagonist, mm-hmm. and we kind of played around the set to stick to this vision. It wasn't an easy shoot.
How did you decide to also let
it happen? Yeah, so it was like stages. In the beginning, it wasn't the idea to do so, mm-hmm. but then later on, we after discussions with the cinematography, we kind of decided like we want to focus on the protagonist and like have a short, the ratio, the aspect ratio, the very tight aspect ratio. And then it was a decision afterwards that we might not show anyone else, because also the female actress canceled on us very late before the shoot. And then we had to play around with this problem. And then I thought maybe we could try out this unique vision, which was made before. Like it was an inspiration from the film Son of Soul. It also had the same vision, and when I saw a couple of shots from that film, I thought that's a very smart idea how to direct a film.
Yeah, inspired
me. Yeah, inspired me a lot. So I thought this is a good chance to use this technique. Mm-hmm. And that
so film. You found the three personalities.
And actually, production-wise, all the female actress says were just one, because I didn't have the money to get different actresses, so I had my mother. And she helped me throughout the film, and she acted all the female actresses. And so yeah, it was a game between what is offered and how to shift it creatively. So I thought maybe all the female actresses is just one voice, but you don't realize it. Different characters that could like give this effect of him listening to his mother throughout the film. You only see him in the frame, and then it's like the voice of his mother is haunting him everywhere. Until we realize it.
My regards to your mother. She is talented.
She's very talented. Yeah. Yeah. So the whole process was like how to fix or find creative solutions to like production and funding problems.
Does anyone have any questions for
you put any weight inside the cat carrier?
Did you know there was like in the beginning we had no idea what to do.
Sure.
Yeah, because there was an actor who's gonna come with his cat.
Right.
But then also he didn't come.
And he didn't show up.
With the cat.
The cat.
He's probably with the actors somewhere.
But actually we found that the sound engineer woke up like on the second day. Right. The first day we shot it with nothing in the box, but we put some weight.
Like, so just, yeah, just like.
Yeah. But then in the second day with the first shot, like. I wanted to show something going inside the box, so it was actually the dead mouse of the mic. So we held it, and then this is what appears in the first frame. But throughout the film, yeah, we just had a couple of books, a jacket, and you know, we tried to put it in an angle that okay, you don't have to see what's inside.
Sure.
So, yeah. But that was it.
My favorite part was in the classroom when you saw a paper walk flying by.
I've noticed you laughing.
Yeah, no, that's great. I'm a teacher, so that was a great detail. Yeah, is this tragic? Yeah. Also, I thought he was taking the cat to be put to sleep. Yeah, so that gave it this sort of with the title and then the cat. Immediately, I was just like, it's a small dog or a cat, and it's gonna, so I'm glad the cat didn't die.
Me too.
And I hope the cat's okay.
Yeah,
the fictional cat.
Are there any questions?
I'm sorry, I don't know if you covered that already. Was the film shot in Cairo? Did you mention?
Yes, it was shot in Cairo.
How is it doing cinema in Egypt?
So this is an independent film. Like I funded myself. But because of that, we had very few options to shoot. So it was my ex-school. So I went there, talked to the manager, I would love to shoot a short film. And very minimum crew. And all the crew members, like Hettings, are like friends from the past. Like my best friend from school, he's the cinematographer. So he works for free. And the art director is not actually an art director, he's an architect. But I thought maybe he'll have a good eye for the frame. And I asked him to do this job for me. And he was okay with that, so I paid no one, kind of, and so it's you'll find your way to make films on a very low budget that hopefully have a good technical look, so it's not amateurish, and until you get the opportunity to maybe have the attention of someone giving you a bigger budget to make a film, but it's definitely difficult to start as a young filmmaker. I don't want to just call it the independent scene, but like the low budget films don't get a lot of chances to be shown in theaters in Cairo, which I think is in most of the cities around the world, not just Cairo. Very few cities give attention to independent filmmakers and young filmmakers. But yeah, it's try your way, find solutions, and it kind of works to make the film in the end anyhow. Yes, I'm actually shooting a short film when I travel back to Cairo. It's also a short film and also the same idea or approach production-wise, like house with my friends or family and a school of, it's also in a house in a school there. So you kind of see what you have and try to make films out of it. And, it was a very old idea, a feature film, but I thought maybe I'll make a short film out of the story, which I love. I believe in that short film very much. And I'm shooting when I go back. It's a coming of age story of a young teenage girl in Cairo. It's a moment of her defying her family authority figures. It's an interesting short film. Yeah.
Yeah.